Hey everybody, welcome to another SciCraft episode. Today we start at the Void Perimeter side again. I made up my mind what to do with the bedrock here on the outside, if we should remove it, or the additional bedrock on the side, if we should maybe redesign some machines in order to remove the last few slices there, and decided against it. I've had enough with bedrock removal, and yeah, it's actually quite a lot of effort in general. Now to start with small scale solutions, when we had the big scale solution running for quite a while. So we kind of limited the bedrock removal for now. In total, we now have a 976 by 976 area as a void perimeter. And we're gonna go for that. So that's 61 by 61 chunks. We actually had to build one more machine because if we only had 975 bedrock blocks removed on one side, so we needed to remove one more slice, which we did by building another 5 wide machine, which barely fit in there. So it was perfect. Alright, so we ran into the end, this can be removed now, and then the next step is building the perimeter wall. So let's quickly go to a creative world where I can show you the design. First idea was to have something like this, so just plain stairs all around the perimeter. Instead of having a vertical wall, I was thinking about the stair wall, because it would have been really nice if you have to transition from normal terrain to the void terrain, and you can just walk down and end up maybe on a little platform here, and here the void would start. So this was the initial idea. Definitely really nice, instead of having a vertical wall, also not more blocks to place, because yeah, instead of just stacking on top of each other, it stretched out. It would have been incredibly easy to build and wouldn't have taken quite a long time, but it was a bit too plain in the end, and yeah, we wanted to go for something a bit fancier. One idea was to build something like this, but yeah, since it's basically a 4,000 block long wall that wraps around the perimeter, this would have taken way too long to build something detailed as this. We have to place stairs in a certain direction all the time and switch between blocks all the time. So we really have to see that we can finish a project. And I'm quite sure this would have taken hundreds of hours to build. So that's why we went for a compromise. We went with this design, which had a huge advantage. It can be easily built or quite fast, because most of the time for like 80% of the blocks, you just have to walk backwards or forwards and place blocks, so place blocks below you. This can be done incredibly fast, and in order to make it a bit more interesting, we added the stairs again. So this would be larger slice of the design. Right, then once we had that, I copied it over to a single player world and used the MC edit to make a large scale design. And this is the fully built up design. So in total it covers a 1100 by 1100 area. So it's quite large. Still looks a bit plain, but I actually really liked it. I think the term for architecture like that is brutalist. It's a lot of concrete and it's a bit gray. I would have actually loved to use more color blocks in there. So, for example, I would have loved to use granite stairs, get a bit more color in there. But I think it's actually looking really interesting as well. So it's definitely something else than a plain vertical wall for once. And yeah, I'm quite pleased with how this turned out. And also that it's still feasible to build this. Because if you look at the material count, I could quickly take a look at the schematic. There we go, material list. We are in total at we can pretty much quickly add it up. So 180, 540, 600, so around 700,000 blocks that need to be placed. And this is obviously quite a lot. But if you keep in mind that we can quickly place those blocks, so if you even would use potions to quickly place those blocks, it's probably not unusual that we can actually average about 20 to 25,000 blocks for the really repetitive part. And in the end, we can probably also use Tweaker Room Mod to quickly place those stairs. So this should still be feasible in, I don't know, at least under 100 man hours with the help of the other SciCrafters. This should be feasible. We've done larger projects like that. Actually, not in terms of materials used. This is actually the largest structure we ever built, of almost 1 million blocks. But yeah, it's really repetitive and easy to build. So back in the Soil world, and this is how it looks like with the Lightmatic loaded in with the overlay. Yeah, as you can already see, we still need to do some terrain removal there in order to have space for the wall. On this side, for example, we already removed so much in the back that we are good. And here you can also see the idea in the end how it should transition to the normal terrain. We will also need to do some terraforming or terrain removal there, so we got a smooth transition. So just dig away some of the hills, maybe fill in areas like that one here, and it should look really nice in the end. So in order to remove the terrain here on the side, of course we're gonna use TNT flying machines, TNT dupers again, and probably don't even need to make a schematic or anything, since we don't need to move it down to bedrock anyway. So we can make kind of a leveled design. So build a TNT duper, then two blocks over and two blocks higher the next one. So it kind of could, yeah, mimic the elevation of the stairs. So usually the reach of a TNT duper is, I think, 85 blocks. So the first TNT duper, what is this? Y35 approximately. That means first TNT duper here on the side would need to be built at Y120. Then we go two blocks over, build the next one at Y122, etc. until yeah, we reach about Y65 for the stairs. So the last one would then be built at Y150. All right, I think we can start with that. I don't think you have to make a custom design for that. I think I'm also gonna use a TNT duper, which is a bit slower, but doesn't make such a huge mess. Wow, flying through the void is actually awful. Zero orientation, and you don't even know if you don't have any blocks to focus on if you're descending or ascending. Yeah, it's really odd. Probably wanna open the F3 menu to not accidentally die in there. That's a bit unfortunate. I just noticed that we can't build this design every second block, even if it's built at a different height, because the blocks still would, the slime blocks here would still connect. Yeah, right there. Can't have that. Couldn't actually build it maybe on the other side. Then we probably have. Wait a minute. If we maybe alternate that part, I mean, that rail can also. Yeah. Why not? I mean, the rail could actually also here lead to the other side, and this would still be functional. So what about the next one? Here we probably run into issues, right? So we need this structure here, and then we definitely run into issues. Maybe we go for this solution, and then we have a a gap in between, so we can build the next one. No, wait a minute. We just don't need to alternate, we just need to make them all face to the left. Then it's perfectly fine, as you can see here. Okay, so we can have it every second block. Awesome. I'm a bit worried that TNT from a higher machine could land on a lower TNT duping module, so that's why I'm gonna do a little small scale test. So let's send all three machines off. Probably should actually put in a redstone line later. Okay. There we go. Wait, the TNT isn't duping? Did I build it correctly? Seems like I can't even build a TNT duper anymore. What did I do wrong? I honestly don't know. Well. I'm gonna check what I did wrong there. Alright, the TNT apparently does dupe on the retraction, but we already lost some. Okay, this is not going great so far. Yeah, of course, I totally forgot that you need an extra block here in the back to make it two-way. So let's try this again. Wait, does it shoot the TNT forward now? It's not supposed to happen. Oh, I should have placed a normal block in the back. Ah, okay. Damn, that's all stuff I actually knew. But if you don't actively use it, then forget about it. Okay, and it seems like the other two lost the TNT again. Does it get updated from the other side? That's probably it. Alright, so at this point it's probably best if you go to the creative world again and try to figure out what's going on. So I already fixed the issue with Rails updating the neighboring TNT, so we launched him a third sequence, we got a 4-tick repeater in between, and that solves the issue that we lose TNT at least. Also works on the way back, but we still had the issue that TNT got propelled forward. And I'm quite sure this is caused by TNT landing on the lower TNT duping module. And also found a solution for that problem. So I replaced the block where the updating detector rail is sitting on with a normal block, and now all the TNT falls straight down. Perfect, just as I wanted it. Alright, now we can build this up in a larger scale, and I think we have to do some terrain removal at least on two sides. And that's what we did in a live stream. So as you can see here, we got enough space now to build the perimeter wall. Perfect. So we can also quickly load the overlay. Yeah, so we can definitely build the wall. There's a single block which still needs to be removed, but yeah, overall, there's definitely enough space. Alright, now we can actually work on building the wall a little bit. We actually made a lot of progress yesterday. Sky Rising was streaming, Freestyle Fox was streaming. So on one side, I think it's already built up halfway now. Or even more. Okay, that's good progress. And I actually got a little helper to build this wall. I captured a horse on one side that helps with the building. Just quickly want to show you that. Yeah, the travel time in those perimeters is insane, but it's nice just to get an overview. Still have to talk about what we're gonna do with that area, if you're gonna cover it up or leave it like that. Okay, here we are. So that's the horse I captured yesterday. Already got a diamond horse armor for it. And yeah, this is actually gonna help building. I'm gonna show you what I mean with that. So how is the horse helpful with building? We're using a client-side mod, Tweakaroo for Master. It has some building options, for example a fast clicker, and it also limits being able to place blocks at a certain layer, and that's what we're using here. So instead of doing it manually, so that's how the player would do it, you could sprint even and reach up to, if I sprint 5.6 meters per second, you can just use a horse and be much faster. So this is a normal average horse, and we can reach up to 4.5 meters per second using the horse. And of course, yeah, this helps a lot with the building, especially if now we would get a splash potion, throw it at the horse, give it some speed 1 or even speed 2, but speed 2 doesn't last long enough to be really worthwhile. So with speed 1, definitely get a bonus. Unfortunately, don't have some on me, but I think we could probably reach even 11 or 12 meters per second. Alright, so horse that I got, found randomly in the savanna biomes around the perimeter, but would definitely be better if we would actually get a decent horse, because this one is also not a great jumper. It can jump up 2 blocks, but for example, it's quite annoying if you jump up 4 blocks like here, the horse just can't do it. So I'm thinking we still have the passive mob area with the old horse sorting area, and I'm quite sure we got a good all-round horse that is reasonably fast and also can jump quite high. So it would be nice if we can get such a horse over there, and then we can build the perimeter wall even faster. And here we are at the old passive mob area project we finished quite a while ago. I think it was over 2 years by now, Minecraft 1.10. That's, by the way, the way down. We had a translocation minecart elevators, which of course no longer work, so the only way to get down now is using ladders. And this is the way down to the horse sorting area, which of course is also now completely non-functional. So there was also heavily translocation based how we sorted those mobs. So the whole redstone contraption here in the back definitely doesn't work anymore. Unfortunately, we have to redo this at some point. Right, but I think we still have some horses in the stables. Let's check. Yeah, the horses were also basically marked here with the signs. So I'm actually searching for a horse that is decently fast and can jump quite high. So this is de definitely our best jumper, 4.75 as far as I can tell. And the top value is speed. 7.4 is one of the fastest horses, so this is the speed per 100 meters. And that would be a great horse if it could jump a little bit higher. Searching for one that can do that would be the perfect horse. 7.75, so this is really fast and can clear 4.5 blocks. Let's just quickly see if you get or if you got a better one. Oh, that one can even jump even higher. But it's just averagely fast. This is our fastest horse, not the donkey, of course. With 7.15 seconds per 100 meters. And you got an exceptionally slow horse. It's actually quite fun. Let's ride this for a moment. Okay. If I turn on the mini HUD mod, yeah. 5.78 meters per second. That's about as fast as a sprinting player. Okay, enough of the fooling around. So let's try to get the horse. Okay. Yeah, that one here, 7.15 meters per second, is actually exceptionally good horse. So on average, you would need to check about 30,000 horses to get one as good as this one here. So we were quite lucky. We checked about 1,000 horses. All right, so where was the good one? Yeah, that one here, 7.75. So this should be decently fast, and also a really good jumper. Let's try it again. This is 4.5 blocks here. Yeah, this is a really good jumper. Actually, it would be such a shame if we lose such a good horse, since we can't really sort him right now. Let's also turn on the mini HUD mod again, so we can reach 12.984 meters per second. All right. Yeah, previously we checked the speed of the horse by just riding down this testing area. Oh, now it just randomly stood up. That's a shame. And there we go. 8.05. Yeah, because it stood up in between. Oh yeah, the way to get back isn't, of course, also translocation based, so we can't use that anymore as well. Just jump down and get back. All right, so we're gonna try to use this horse. First thing, we need to find a way up. And I'm quite sure we probably need to build something. Something else we didn't really consider. Because, of course, the horse weren't able to use the translocation elevator. We kind of need a flying machine horse elevator here. This would be, of course, the perfect solution. But I'm just probably gonna dig a way up through the Nazarek. Alright, so thanks to the Nazarek tunnel here, we can only leave this place again. But we should actually return at some point and, yeah, just fix it up, repair everything, replace the old redstone, and just try to get this to work again somehow. Alright, so I made this tunnel here. Perfect for the horse. No problem. And I think we can actually ride through the piston bolt tunnel to get back to the Nether Hub. Yep, this is definitely possible. Just gonna put. Stay in there. Just gonna put the glass panes back in, and then we can go over to the void perimeter area. Let's also make a quick stop at the brewing system. So I'm gonna make some splash potions of swiftness 1. And let's get some horse armor as well. So we still have some left over. It's actually also one of the items we don't have a double chest of, the diamond horse armor. Got it for the gold, shulker boxes here. And for iron, of course. So maybe we need to search a bit. To also get a double chest of that at some point. All right. Gonna wait a little bit until the potion is finished. Okay, so we're using one of the ice tunnels just to get the corner of the void perimeter. And also interesting fact, I did not notice before. Horses are slow on ice, so we can now only reach about 11 meters per second. Did not know that. Really interesting. Also, the player is just ever so slightly slower than usual. So instead of the 4.3 meters per second, only 4.15 meters per second. Right. Also did not know that. So in order to bring the horse to the building site, we're gonna take a leap of faith, place some slime at the bottom. Oh god. Oof. Okay, the horse actually took some damage. Oof. Maybe you should also get some healing potions soon. Alright, but what I'm really interested right now is how fast is the horse with some splash potions of swiftness one? Alright, get him right here. Let's splash the horse. There we go. And now we can reach 15.58 meters per second. Right, this is gonna help a lot building. It's like 3 times as fast as a sprinting player without any potion. So yeah, this is gonna be a big help. Alright, we're back at the building site. Time to test out the horse. And of course, it's super fast. Oh, awesome. That's gonna help so much with building. There are unfortunately some restrictions what we can do with the horse. For example, now placing the next row of stone bricks here is something I really don't want to do with the horse, because the best way to do it normally is to align myself in a 45 degree angle and then sprint forward. But I really don't want to risk a horse falling down, yeah, maybe even falling into lava and dying, because yeah, at the moment we can't really get such a good horse back really easily. So I'm gonna just place some of the blocks still manually, maybe I can even splash potion myself. There we go. It's also interesting, you might not notice, I also did not notice for a while. If you walk diagonal, you can actually walk faster than just going straight. So that's something we can easily test with the mini HUD mod, top left, hope you can read it. For 5.18 meters per second, now if I align myself in a 45 degree angle, press A and W, wait, actually without sprinting, 5.28 meters per second. So it's just slightly faster, and this also works with sprinting, so sprinting 6.73. If I sprint diagonal, we can reach 6.827. Right, so if I don't fall down here, I can easily surf the elytra. Don't want to risk the horse for that. But before we continue with the building, we should maybe focus on terrain removal so we can start building on all four sides finally. Because it's also a bit quicker and more convenient if you could just keep placing the same type of blocks instead of just 1,000 blocks in a row and then turn around. If you can just go all around the perimeter and place the same type of blocks 4,000 times, it's just a bit more convenient. Alright, what I already did here is build a second TNT duper array, because this is actually the side we need to remove the most terrain, because the edge of the void perimeter is really close to the wall here. So we need to bomb down actually up to Y20, and if we would have built the machine that removes blocks up to Y20, then it would have blown itself up because the terrain was just so high. That's why we need the second array in order to get some clearance first. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna continue with this project between the episodes, hopefully. Still hope we can finish this maybe in the next 2 weeks and then finally start playing Cyblock. Thanks guys so much for watching, see you on the next one, bye bye!